Take your neighbor's new recruit. Careful, it all that years. SY920 is one of my regular stops, so I already have the necessary approvals. Neighbor says you're after a piece of UC tech. So together, we're going to need to get you on board. I can do that, but I have conditions. Good. If I can be candid, for this job to work, we'll have to do this my way. You take my ship, and you're a member of my crew. But make no mistake, once you board, the risk is entirely yours. This route is highly lucrative, and sacrificing it is not an option. It's not personal. If you're caught, that entire installation will be on you. There's nothing I can do for you at that point. Except send flowers to your next of kin. Look, I know I don't have a lot of history with the fleet, but I'm putting my reputation and ship on the line for this. That alone should tell you enough. Whew, then we have a deal. In any case, when you're ready, meet me at my ship. It's the Jade Swan. And make sure you're prepared for the long haul. Once you're on board SY920, you can't come and go as you please. What I've been told. Get you on the SY920, get you out. That being said, I can be a better guide if I know what it is we're after. It's up to you. Fine by me. If this goes bad, the less I know, the better. And if I do get caught, there'll be nothing to confess to. Enough to be on the first name basis with the Marines working the comps. It also helps they want us to dock. The cargo ship needs supplies, special requests, slates from home. In the void of space, a cargo hauler is a soldier's best friend. I'd like to, but I need to keep a low profile. In my experience, the more people know about you, the more they have over you. True, but silence is a powerful thing. I find the best way to get to know someone is to watch them work. Talking just muddies the picture. Anyways, I appreciate the small talk. Delgado's crew aren't usually so chatty. But let's keep our focus on the mission. We can swap bar stories and share scars when we've got enough creds to buy the bar and fix the scars. We'll talk more on the ship.
Looking for the next mark.
Hmm.
All right, a few things to know. When we get to the checkpoint, UC military will be hailing us. Let me do the talking. Return your piece of cargo if you have to. Good. Say nothing and let their minds fill in the gaps. Now, like I said before, once we take off, there's no turning back until this job is done. If you need to take care of anything before we leave, do it. If you want to ask me any other questions, go for it. All right, then get comfortable. We leave for SY920 immediately.
All crew prepare for takeoff. Routing power to engine and grab drive. All systems go.
We'll graph jump the SY920 from here. Don't worry about your personal ship. The fleet will make sure it's secure. You can take this time to prepare. Yes, try not to bother my pilot while they're flying.
Don't worry, Captain. I've spent half my life walking and chewing gum at the same time. I can handle a little bit.
Sounds like you're putting in a request for double duty.
Captain, I retract my earnest. For the record, I don't even know.
Noted. Just get us there safe.
Roger that.
Okay, we're in. First things first. The station is enormous, with checkpoints everywhere. To get past them, you'll need a military uniform. And to get a uniform, you'll need to get to the barracks. There should be a way through the vents. You can get to them via the maintenance door downstairs. There's an intercom there as well, where we can make contact. Once you get a uniform, it should be fairly easy to find an elevator to the command bay. But if at any point your cover's blown, I'm gone. I would hope not. But if they do, we'll cross that bridge when we get there. Either way, for now, get on that station and find that intercom. We'll talk more then.
Hello.
Yes?
Jade Swan. Loading and unloading only.
Stay clear of the military barracks.
Hold up. This area is for SY920 military only. Yeah, you do that.
All this cargo hauling is making me hungry.
Should be in front of you. If you can find a way to open it, it'll get you past the first checkpoint. I'm not worried. I'm sure you'll figure it out. Anyway, the door will let you access the vents. Go up the vents and to the barracks. You should find a uniform there. The uniform should get you through the checkpoint and to the elevators. We'll talk again once you get to the command bay.
Everything looks clear.
State your business.
Logging and sin level clearance. Go on ahead.
I don't know you. Need your clearance code, Marine. All right, Ensign, let's hear it. You're clear, Ensign Akasaka. stop right there, Ensign. All right, Ensign. Why aren't you at your post? Who's your commanding officer? Only authorized personnel are allowed here. Only senior officers report to the commander. Something doesn't seem right. Glad you understand the position I'm in here. Yeah, I remember now. I hear you. I'll let you go, Ensign. But as soon as you're done with your task, you should return to your post.
Not to change the subject, but are we concerned about potential leaks?
No. Until you can provide more substantial proof, we'll simply monitor. I trust you have no issues moving further. It was an honor to work with a true professional. Good luck. If you make it out alive, next time you're at the Nova, I'll buy you a drink.
Results in risk increased by a magnitude of 2. But we won't tell Commander Natar. Wait, who are you? Why are you in here? Did you not see the sign?
yes. I've been studying decryption of all types for quite a long time. Probably since before you took your first crab job. Signal protocol, quantum ratchet symmetry, interleaving data extrapolation. You name it, I've lectured on it. I've probably forgotten half of it, but I definitely know it works. Don't you mean access to the ship? Because the comm spike isn't a device, it's a module. It's attached to a prototype in one of our docking ports. We're still in the testing phase, running decryptions across a variety of signal types. But the results so far have been very promising. It can even interpolate signal data lost in the retrieval. It really is a wondrous technology. Yes. It's not quite cracking the Enigma code, but it will give us a significant tactical advantage. We'll be able to infer everything from battle plans to meal consumption. Not that we care about that sort of thing. Outside of the effects of diet on combat readiness. And yes, there are certain things to be worked out, missing parts and the occasional traumatic injury here and there, but it's all part of the adventure. Yes, it's not the destination, but the journey that matters. Particularly when the destination's there. But don't worry. We've corrected the problem with the ship's life support systems, and statistical models show a failure rate of less than 2%. In short, I've requested a full squadron of these brave and fearless Marines to be transferred to the station. They'll give the prototype a final run, and provided there are minimal casualties, present our findings to MAST. Splendid. That was fast. I thought I put in the request this morning. Normally my requests aren't given this much attention, let alone haste. It seems a tad suspicious. You're right. We do need to hurry if we're going to have this module ready. That is true. Ah, yes. The wheels of bureaucracy tend to have corners. Maybe it's not the worst thing in the world if we come from. Classified, I'm the head of the Comm Spike Project. I would have gotten word of this ahead of time. I'm sorry, but I don't believe you. Now, if you don't have any further... Intercepting transponder data in the Hoffa system might be promising. Wait, who are you? Why are you in here? Did you not see the sign? Oh yes, I've been studying decryption of all types for quite a long time. Probably since before you took your first crab jump. Signal protocol, quantum ratchet symmetry. Interleaving data extrapolation. You name it, I've lectured on it. I've probably forgotten half of it, but I definitely know it works. Don't you mean access to the ship? Because the comm spike isn't a device, it's a module. It's attached to a prototype in one of our docking ports. We're still in the testing phase, running the cryptons across a variety of signal types. But the results so far have been very promising. It can even interpolate signal data lost in the retriever. It really is a wondrous technology. Yes, it's not quite cracking the Enigma code, but it will give us a significant tactical advantage. We'll be able to infer everything from battle plans to meal consumption. Not that we care about that sort of thing. Outside of the effects of diet on combat readiness. And yes, there are certain things to be worked out, missing parts and the occasional traumatic injury here and there, but it's all part of the adventure. Yes, it's not the destination, but the journey that matters. Particularly when the destination is death. But don't worry, we've corrected the problems with the ship's life support systems, and statistical models show a failure rate of less than 2%. In short, I've requested a full squadron of these brave and fearless marines to be transferred to the station. They'll give the prototype a final run, and provided there are minimal casualties, we can present our findings to MAST. Splendid! That is MAST. I thought I put in the request this morning. Normally my requests aren't given this much attention, let alone haste. It seems a tad suspicious. You're right. We do need to hurry if we're going to have this module ready. Ah, yes. The wheels of bureaucracy tend to have corners. Maybe it's not the worst thing in the world if you cut them. I see. It would have been nice if they kept me in the loop. I am the project lead, after all. All right, you've convinced me. You're the new task pilot. You will need a uniform and a terminal password to authorize a flight and get past the tower's cumbersome checkpoints. The uniform you can get in the locker room area, the password. You'll find the prototype ship at docking bay. Use the password to access the flight terminal in the control center. And of course, that's the thing. You are doing science a great service by undertaking this.
Stressed out thinking about this project.
You'll find the prototype ship in docking bay 8. Use the password to access the flight terminals in the control center.
The lowdown. We'll take care of things from here.
That's a real nice ship you brought in. I can't wait to tinker with it.
Thank you.
know Neva was right about you. It's good to have a promising rookie with the fleet. I won't deny I helped. Let's hope the compensation reflects that, huh? Anyway, I believe I owe you a drink. It's the last time I'm paying, of course. Because if Delgado's right about Crix's legacy, you've earned more than your fair share already with that comm spike. Sounds like you're on board as a true believer. I have to admit, the way things are going, I'm starting to believe myself. Anyway, I've kept you long enough. Now that you've had your drink and my debt is paid, it's time for you to give Delgado the good news.
Jasmine tells me that you not only brought us the comm spike, but an entire prototype piece of shit. Very impressive.
Should've taken the compliment, Rook. Dale doesn't get those out often. Juan gave us the full rundown of your little smash-and-grab operation. She gave you some really high praise. Said you were a pro.
From what I hear, receiving praise from Juan Dayu is quite an accomplishment. All in all, a job well done. Now, on to the business at hand. Jasmine, are you there?
Yes, what's up?
How's it going?
I already got two of my crew tearing the ship apart from one end to the other. Comm spike shouldn't be too tough to extract. I'm looking forward to seeing what those EC techs have been up to.
Keep me posted. All right, that leaves our electromagnetic atmosphere problem. I think it's coming. There's a corporation in the city of Neon called Generator. They're responsible for the massive production grid that powers the city. We get our hands on their electrical absorption tech, and Jasmine swears she can take it to have their line of port. It's the giant shroud that covers the entire city. Big ugly thing that Jennifer needs. When you arrive in Neon, I'm sure you'll find that the very red dog in the morning.
You damn right she can. My girl can piece together a jump engine with her eyes shut. Literally, I've seen her do it. Lost good money on that bet.
All right, that's gonna get carried away. Now, why don't you give us the info on our Neon company?
You get to meet up with the lovely Estelle Vincent. She's had her deft little fingers on the pulse of Neon for some time now. Whatever info you need, I guarantee she can give
you. Estelle is one of the most reliable captains we have on the fleet. If I want something done, there's none of the typical bullshit. She gets done, and afterward, we all split the cash. No, no, no. There is no getting along here. You are going to do everything she asks. Follow her instructions to the letter. She is valuable to the fleet. You piss her off and we lose her as a contact, you're going to be answering to me.
Estelle will be waiting at Madame Savage's place. I say don't keep her waiting, but chances are she won't. Girl loves her there.
Keep your eyes on the price. Neon's one big distraction for people like us. I want you focused. We are one step away from Crix's legacy, and we cannot afford any screws.
Cool. stay under the radar.
Things were a little too loose on the
team. It's good to have you back.
It seems you had quite the eventful mission. You still have the Crimson Fleet's trust, and you were able to spare lives in the process. But you did so in abundance of stealth and restraint. It's exactly what we're looking for to assist their operative.
Excuse me, sir. I hate to interrupt, but there's still the matter of the comms fight to discuss.
Yes, of course, Lieutenant. Time is short, and we should get to the matter at hand. Please give me your report. With the acquisition of the comms fight, the fleet is one step closer to Crix's legacy. And the more people we arrest, the greater the chance that your infiltration is discovered. We're working against the clock here, so let's start by discussing the status of the comm spike. And it's just a matter of time before she reverse engineers it to fit the fleet's purposes. So what does Delgado have you doing next? Has he solved the Bannock 4 problem? Conduction grid?
That's brilliant, but is it actually possible? It's 80-year-old tech. Sorry, sir. The conduction grid is how Neon generates its power. It essentially absorbs lightning strikes and converts it to usable energy. It would take a hell of an engineer to modify the technology to handle Bannock 4's EM field. An engineer like Jasmine Durand.
That's the case. Inform our contacts on Neon that our operative will be touching down there in the near future.
Absolutely, sir.
And before you depart, I wanted you to know that your efforts are helping us gain interest among my superiors. They're finally beginning to believe that we can take down the Crimson Fleet and make amends for the UC's embarrassing mistake. Of course I am, but it's a calculated risk. The fact that our common enemy owes its existence to the United Colonies, of course. It was the riot at the lock, touched off by Jasper Crix, that inspired him to create the Crimson Fleet in the first place.
Thanks to your assistance, we'll be able to rectify that mistake, and Mast will authorize an all-out assault.
It's long overdue. All right, I suppose that's all for now. I'll be looking forward to your next report. Good luck. Please, be careful.